Hi, in today's video I want to show you the entire baseline for Lynyrd Skynyrd's Freebird, what I believe is the studio version of it, done by, Leon Wilkinson was the kind of main bass player for Lynyrd Skynyrd. I think there was a bass player before that did the original recording, but he's the one that you see in all the videos, etc., from the 1970s. I'm going to show you the version you would hear on the original soundtrack. Right, I've got it off of a play-along on YouTube, someone playing along to it really well. So what you want to do, there's lots of YouTube players that actually do very good versions of it. That's why I'm not going to do a play-along. I'm just going to show you the notes. And it's a look and learn, as usual, so I ain't going to bang on about what note is what, because I'm too lazy to learn them. And just look, learn, rewind the video, play it back again, etc. The song is a very long song altogether, with the melodic bit and the solo. It's about 9 minutes 35. So I'm going to try and break it down into chunks so you can see how the whole thing is constructed. Then just listen to it, watch the play-alongs and fit it all together. So I ain't going to hang about, you know, not too many repeats, etc. So right, let's go, let's just crack on. So we start with the introduction. You want to see the bass, not my face. Here we go. I've got a kind of isolated drums video set up here. So this is sort of isolates the drums and turns everything else down. And it's in the key of G, by the way. Okay, here it is. This is the introduction. Slowly. Here we go. Look and learn. And this is a hammer-on. Okay, I'll just do that again because it's right at the high end of the register. And then it goes into the introduction, this sort of instrumental introduction, let's call it. So let's have a look at that. I'm just going to rewind this a touch. Okay, so that leads up to the vocals kicking in, and there are the dreaded variations, unfortunately. So in this, here we go, it starts like this. Ready? So after you've done that, it goes goes straight into the this sort of instrumental introduction. Ready? Actually, I got that wrong. Here we go. Right, so it goes. This is all the same, that's why I'm doing this fast. So all the difference is the first time round it goes, and then the next time round it's, you know, instead of going, it's, yeah. And the vocals kick in. You have that slide, and you have another slide here. Okay, so let's just play that. This is going to take longer than I thought. I'm going to wind the touch. Okay, so that's it. Thank you. Here's the second time round I got it right. Is that slide that was messing us up. Right, so here, this is it. It's going to be easier for us to slow down. So when the vocals kick in, there is something slightly different. It goes... So this is the different bit. Is this slide here, so it goes, so instead of using that one, you're using this one, you're sliding to the octave, and then we go to here as normal. And now this, remember that kind of instrumental introduction? The second time round you went, that's the norm, that's what you do every time the verse rolls round again with the singing, and then it goes, this is the bit I was messing up, it's twice on here. You back again. It's exactly the same. I got it right then. Right, so that's that, and that just keeps rolling round and round until he says, and this bird you'll never change. There's a bit where he says, and this bird you'll never change, and then something slightly different happens, and then it goes into the chorus. So I'm going to play it up until then. I might just skip it a little bit. Change, and then you get the fill that leads you into the chorus goes like this. Just look and learn. So everything, I'm just going to keep saying the same, the same, the same until it gets different. Yeah. So it goes. There's the slide. I didn't put that in that. This is all the same. Mm-hmm. And then back again. Keep rolling that round. In fact, I'll just play it, and then it goes back into the chorus again, and everything I've already shown you gets repeated, and then we get to the fast bit. So I might as well just play that. See what the notes are, so you just have to ignore the cock-ups. So once it goes, you know, for about the third time, you go back into the chorus, right? It's exactly the same as what I've just shown you, but without the introduction, obviously. Without this, obviously. Back into that pre-introduction, that instrumental introduction. But it does it the other way around. It goes. And then the next time round. Just twist it around, then the vocals kick in, and that's exactly the same, you know. Yeah, okay, that keeps rolling over and over until we get to the this bird you'll never change, so that's exactly the same, that. Okay, that's exactly the same, and then, but the, instead of once you, and then the final one of those is where Ronnie Van Zant says, "And this bird you'll never," and then it goes, and then we're going into this, the really fast bit, the guitar solo and bass solo and drum solo, the whole lot. Yep. So you do exactly the same. So what you do is you go. Okay, so I'm going to speed it up to that. Play it. Try and play along with it. I really balls this up big time. It's so hard to go with it. So I'm just going to show you the different chunks of it. Right. I'm going to speed this right up. Thank you. sorry, but that was just appalling. I'm going to do it again, and I'm going to get that, do that better. Up. I think it's I'm more nervous about playing this when I'm recording the lesson. Normally I get that right every single time. Not. So I need to practice that. That's the bit I really, really need to practice. I haven't got sussed out yet, you know. But I know all the notes, but it's getting up the speed is bloody difficult. And you know, I'll get there. It's gonna be it's one of my sort of ambitions to get that right up to speed and do a real good play along with it. Okay, so, but you just want to see the notes. So, okay, so once it goes, do, you know. You get one more without that, so it's. This is an important one to learn, yeah? Of the licks, the variations of it come off of that, you know. You know, all of that stuff comes off of it, but there are completely different, you know, playthroughs, you know, plays of the, you know, bass, what do you call it, phrases that go through the whole cycle, you know. So this is one cycle. Thank you. then the phrase changes. The phrase then changes to this. The, let's call it the rollover of this guitar solo. You know, it's basically these notes rolling over. You know. Obviously the bass guitarist is doing all sorts of twiddly bits and things like that off of them. So that's one. The second, I'm gonna go through these quick now. The second one, and I'm gonna play a couple of them. I don't know whether I should really do this, but let's. After the one I've just shown you, you have this. You do that one four times, yeah, and then it goes into this one. That one is just three times, yeah, and then after that it does this. It does that one four times, yeah? So I'm going to play those two, try and play along to it. I'm going to absolutely bodge it all up, but I've got to move forward, and then I'll show you both of them slowly. Yeah, so then we've got two out of the way. Thank you. last one, I got it right. Yep, ish. You had to put up with some pretty appalling playing there. So, we'll go through those slowly and quickly, if you know what I mean. So, one. So, the first one is just this. Sorry. We've already seen that one. This one is... something slightly different after that, which is that. And I'm not going to play along to that, I'm just going to play it through, because that's all it is. You go... You've just seen that it's straightforward, it's just pump, 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 and then you just load of hammer-ons there, yeah? Some people do it much faster than that. So, boom, boom, pump, pump, boom, and you can even put a slide in here. Yeah. Luckily, I got this next bit right, which is amazing. Right as I can get it. So once it gets to the last, you do that four times, yeah. So once it gets to the fourth one of these, it goes back to. Okay, and you do that one four times. Okay, so here we go. It goes like this. Thank you. okay, so this is it, to be fair on you. Open E. Four times, and then you get this rolling. And that goes four times, yeah. And all you're doing is going one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and two and three and four. And that's how I kind of do it, yeah. You do that four times, and then it does this. Like this to get into that bit that climbs all the way down here to that little solo, that little twiddly bit down here, the level nasty as I call it. So I'm just going to show you it, and once you see the notes and you learn it, you'll be able to fit that over the song. You can't really hear it on this drum solo, you see. Okay, so the isolated drums. Yeah, right, okay, because the drum is just the same all the way through. So once you've done that, this. On the last one, the fourth one, you do this. And that takes you into that one that goes all the way down there. So it goes. Octave of the G is the first one. Just two on each one, yeah? Then you repeat that here. And then when you get to here, you do this. It's meant to be more gallopy, but I can't do that, so it goes. And then you go back up to here again. Then to here. And then when you get to here, you go. Sorry, you don't. You go. Three times, and then you do what the hell you want until the end. So you do whatever you want really until you get to the end, and on the in the concert versions you'll hear a special ending where they go. Show you that twiddly bit again and show you how I completely balls that up. So it's after this. So I'll do the whole thing. Watch how you don't do it. Watch me completely screw this up. Little twiddly bit, you see. okay, that that was awful. It was terrible. But hopefully, if you bear with the video, if you can do it without, I don't know, setting yourself on fire or something like that, this is about the only one on here that shows you all the notes. So, you know, I could have done it quicker, I suppose. There were lots and lots of mistakes, but, you know, I got through it, and, you know, you should be able to see the notes and the phrases, learn it, and do it much better than me. I've still got to really get, obviously, I've still got to get this up to speed, big time, and, you know, I'm going to go back to practicing it again, and I will get it up to speed, and I will get it so I can play the whole thing all the way through, because I think once you can play this all the way through, it's going to make a lot of other bass lines seem a lot easier. Okay, well, I hope that wasn't too painful, and I'll make another video another day and stick it up here for another bass line. See ya.